Well, you're all very welcome to this Return to America Travel Trade webinar series, which is brought to you by Visit USA and ITTN. As we prepare for the return of transatlantic travel, this is the perfect opportunity to get up to speed on what to expect from a return to our favorite destinations across the United States in a post-COVID world. I'm Fionn Davenport. I'm the group editor for ITTN. And in this first webinar, we're going to talk to Jenny Rafter, who is the chairperson of the Visit USA Committee in Ireland, and Tony Lane, who is the executive director of the Visit USA Committee Ireland. You're both very welcome. Okay, so Jenny, let's start with the obvious one. Tell us a bit more about the Visit USA Committee Ireland.
Yeah, Fionn, the Visit USA Committee in Ireland is a non-profit organization, and we have over 75 members that range from airlines, attractions, airports, tour operators, travel agencies, and cruise lines. And, you know, our main aim is basically to promote the visitation from Ireland to the US, both to the consumer and the trade. But we're a really useful resource for the travel trade in Ireland, where they can go in and access training, content. We offer promotional activity for offers via our website, emails, and across our media channels. But not only that, we also do quite a lot of trade events throughout the year. So we've got a roadshow taking place this year in September in Cork and Dublin on the 13th and 14th of September. That are really great opportunities for our trade to attend. And we also have a date in the diary that's never missed. It's our Thanksgiving trade night, which takes place on the 18th of November. That's taking place in Dublin, and that's a fantastic night for the trade to come along, for us to show our appreciation, and for our members to tell the trade about what's new in their destination or their attraction. So, yeah, we're delighted to be part of this, and we're delighted that ITTN are giving us this opportunity to communicate to the trade.
So we've launched this travel trade webinar, this Return to America. So what is your ambition for it?
Yeah, this is really about kind of preparing the trade for the return to transatlantic flying and what they should expect. So as Tony mentioned, we're going to have 25 members taking part in this, where they'll be able to give updates of what's happening at their destination, at their attraction, whatever it may be. So it's really for, you know, the travel trade to refresh their knowledge of selling the US product.
And Tony, obviously, here we are looking forward to getting out of this COVID situation. So what is the situation in the United States like right now?
It goes without saying that, like, last year, the United States was very badly affected by COVID-19. And I think we all saw the kind of news stories that were there about the different states being affected. But what we're not really seeing is the incredible success that they've been having since the beginning of the year with their vaccination program. And it's really like a wartime effort in terms of their rollout. They've had a tremendous success. And I mean, at the moment, you know, it's about 70% of the population have gotten at least one dose, and about 57% are actually fully vaccinated. So they're very far advanced in their vaccination program. And in response to this, because the public health situation has increased so markedly, it means that restrictions right across the straits, across the states, has begun to being lifted actually back in May. So things are actually gone back to almost back to normal in the various states, which is really, really great to see. I mean, we have indoor dining in most states. We have big events, big sporting events, concerts that are being held with full capacities. The attractions are more or less back with some restrictions. And there is a differentiation, you know, that's been made by the CDC between people who are fully vaccinated and those who are still awaiting, you know. But for people who are fully vaccinated, there are very little in the way of restrictions. So very much on track to being back to normal.
So when do you think we can expect normal travel to resume?
It's a thing that, you know, I mean, we do have, you know, a couple of obstacles still there at the moment. We've obviously got the US travel ban, which has been in place since last March, and that's, you know, very unfortunate. We also have the Irish government's advice against non-essential travel. But I think it's really important to keep in mind that the conditions on both sides of the Atlantic are becoming right for those bans to be lifted. You know, as I said, the actual vaccine situation in the States is very advanced. We're also doing very, very well here. We're not quite as far advanced as the United States, but we're definitely getting there. And, you know, in terms of the actual mechanism to allow for, you know, people to travel again, I mean, obviously, we've got the EU's COVID cert that Ireland has signed up for and that we understand will be in place by July the 19th. That should facilitate travel within Europe, which will be great. But we know that there are technical discussions underway between the EU and the US to make their two systems mutually recognizable. So that's a work in progress, and it's very encouraging to see that that's happening. So there are a few things yet to go in terms of things falling into place to allow for it to happen again. It's looking very good, and we would anticipate that, you know, normal travel should resume sometime a little bit later on this year.
And Jenny, what makes America so special?
Well, I think there's like huge, strong links between Ireland and the US, and there's such a high proportion of Irish diaspora living in the US. But for a holiday destination, you know, the United States is incredibly unique and a really exciting destination. I mean, for a start, the land mass is massive. You know, it offers such diversity in terms of landscape, you know, from the forests of New England to Everglades of Florida, deserts of Nevada. So, you know, you can have a really diverse vacation depending on, you know, where you want to travel to. But not only that, I think, you know, just the culture, the food, the music, you know, with the US having, you know, immigrants coming over so many years, it offers so much diversity and range. So you can have whatever type of vacation you like. But also, I suppose, a point to mention is that there's quite a lot of cities that have gone in, you know, an incredible urban renewal over the last 20 years. So destinations like Denver and Atlanta. So many city destinations, so much outdoor space, a real wide range of destinations and holiday vacation types you can experience in the US.
Tony, America is still a popular destination with Irish people, is it not?
It certainly is. And, you know, it's a thing that, like, Irish people travel to the United States more per person than any other country in the world. And, you know, even though we're a small country, 5 million people, you know, we're actually in the top 20 for visitation to the US, which is really, really great. And I mean, to put it into perspective, like 1 in 10 people, 1 in 10 Irish people will travel to the United States every year. So it's a very high frequency and above and beyond our neighbors in Europe go to the States. But it seems like that, you know, even the kind of trends that we're seeing, you know, I mean, yes, you know, we've got the family holidays to Florida and California to see the theme parks and that kind of thing and combine it with a beach holiday. That is perennially popular, which is great. Fly drives are absolutely increasing in popularity every year. And I don't know, perhaps it was a little bit of a mental block that people had about driving in the States up until recently. That seems to be evaporating and people are just really into doing it now. And there really is no better way to see the United States than getting into a car and checking it out. You know, being able to see the incredible scenery, as Jenny said, you know, it's just so diverse and just vast and amazing. But as well as that, it's also, you know, that the kind of things that you can see between the cities, the Americana, a lot of the time that's almost the most interesting and unique stuff that you can see when you go to the States. So really great experience to be had. But we've also got, you know, people go over, we've got great kind of, you know, escorted and self-guided culture trips that go over. And we've even got city breaks, you know, when city breaks to New York, Boston, you know, they're always really, really popular for a few days. So there's a whole range, you know, of, you know, things that types of trips that Irish people can do. And, you know, we're very hopeful that it's going to, you know, when normal travel gets going again, that, you know, that the Irish will return en masse.
I'm really looking forward to this travel trade webinar series. I mean, obviously, it's for the travel trade to brush up on their US knowledge. But I'm looking forward to hearing from the 25 members that are going to participate, because I really want to brush up on my knowledge of the United States. So my thanks to the two of you, to Tony Lane, the Executive Director for the Visit USA Committee Ireland, and of course to Jenny Rafter, who's the Chairperson of the Visit USA Committee Ireland. Thank you very much.